Hello and welcome back to the Bielsa Stan YouTube channel. Hope everyone is well. This is a new video for all you wonderful people. Today we are continuing with the series of that ex-Leeds United player, and the player we'll be talking about is Matthew Pennington. Let's talk about his early career first. So he started out at Everton, joining the club at 11 years old. And he played for the youth ranks. He obviously made appearances in the Premier League as well as the League Cup. He actually made his debut for the Toffees in August 2015, which he played against Barnsley. He also won the under-23 Premier League title with Everton, where he made a good contribution, I believe, in the 2016 to 2017 squad. However, in the 15-16 season, he started or played in the last four Premier League matches of that campaign. I think his debut in the Premier League was against Anfield, was against Liverpool at Anfield. And then whilst he was Everton, he made several loan moves. So let's go over his loan moves now. So in 2014, he joined the likes of Tranmere Rovers. That season, I think he also, or the next season, 2014-15, he joined Coventry City, making 24 appearances. Walsall, he also went on loan in 2016. Then he joined Leeds United for the season of 2017-18. After that season, the season after, he actually signed his new contract after he came back and went on a pre-season tour to Africa with the Everton squad, I think. When he came back from his loan from Leeds United, he then went to Ipswich Town on a loan, scoring one goal. The season after that, he joined Hull City, and then Shrewsbury the season after that. So the season of 2020-2021, he then joined Shrewsbury Town, which probably was when his contract ended. So he probably joined them on a free. And he was there for 2 years until this summer. He made 82 appearances, scoring 7 goals. They offered him a new contract this summer. He declined and he wanted to join Blackpool in League One, where he's made 7 appearances in the league so far this season. He's made an appearance in the EFL Cup as well as the EFL Trophy Cup. So, he's playing his trade at League One. At the moment, he also has a cap for England under-19s. He's made an appearance there in 2013. Now, let's talk a bit more about his Leeds career. So, he obviously joined Leeds for a season. He made his debut against Bolton Wanderers, where Leeds actually won that game. Apparently, the loan fee was about £500,000, £500k for the season. During his debut, he actually picked up an injury. So he was substituted in the second half. He didn't make an appearance, I think, till October, where Leeds United were very inconsistent. He then started games for Leeds and was back in the starting 11 and back in the picture of Leeds United probably to the end of the season. So he made 24 appearances throughout that season. And then at the end of the season, he went back to Everton, and that was really his Leeds career. When he signed, I wasn't that excited, to be honest. I mean, he's probably a lower championship player to League One player. I thought he'd more or less be back up to Cooper and Janssen. Now, if you can't remember the season he was at Leeds United, this was a season where Thomas Christensen did join Leeds United. He was sacked, then Paul Heckingbottom came in and did an awful job with Leeds for that second half of the season, and we finished 13th. We did awful in the FA Cup, as always, in that season. In the EFL Cup, we actually got knocked out in the fourth round. Now, Kamal Roof was our top scorer, and we had players that season like Andy Lonergan in the squad, Javoy Grant, right? Lasonga was also on loan, if you remember. He came from Germany for a season where he was a bit of a disappointment. We had the likes of Samuel Saye still at the squad, Hadi Sacco, Ronaldo Vieira, Anita, Tyler Denton, Wilkes, Click was here, Tom Pearce, Jack Clark, Liam Kitching, and Luke Murphy. So a pretty much championship squad where we started very well under Christensen. I think during Christmas time we were in the playoffs, were we? And then second half of the season was awful. He got the sack, Christensen, and Heckingbottom came in and Holly won the game. And then obviously that season after was Marcelo Bielsa's first season in charge of Leeds United. So he had an okay time at Leeds. As I say, he's now playing his trade in League One, where that's probably his level. I mean, Blackpool did get relegated. They're probably one of the favourites to go back up of League One. Let's have a quick look at the League One table to see where Blackpool are. Blackpool actually aren't in the top six, surprisingly. They are seventh, just out of the top six. So they're on 20 points out of 13 games, making 5 wins, 5 draws, 3 losses. So he's doing okay at a League One side, I guess. So yeah, that's a bit about Matthew Pennington's career. I think probably in the early days of Everton, he had quite a lot of potential. He just hasn't lived up to it. He's been a bit of a lonely out player, where he obviously was at Everton for all those years. He didn't really make an appearance or make a contribution to Everton. He made 7 appearances, I think, overall in the first team in the league, but he didn't break through, unfortunately for him. And then Shrewsbury Town, he played for, who were, I think, in League One last season, if I'm mistaken. So yeah, he's on that level of League One, even though he's had Premier League experience. He's now 29, so he's getting old, reaching that peak time of his career. So yeah, do you remember Matthew Pennington's time at Leeds United? What was your favourite moment of his in the Leeds United shirt? Do you think he was a good signing? Do you think he was worth the 500k loan signing? Let me know in the comments below. Would you have him back at the team? I certainly wouldn't. Again, he'd be like not very good if we had him. But yeah, I mean, the overall season whilst he was here, let's quickly just talk about that again. Like, we started well under Christensen, I mean, but then, I don't know, because according to this, Leeds United were inconsistent. So, here we go. So, yeah, we started the season off very well. Then, after the 9th league game, we had 6 losses and 1 draw. That was probably when Matthew Pennington came back into the squad. Game 17, we actually won, and we had a bit of a good period there where we won 4 out of 6 matches, so he was probably part of that. And then towards the end of the season, when Heckingbottom was in charge, we lost the majority of the games, only winning 2 games in that match. So yeah, I mean, when we were going through the bad period in October, he came back in the squad. So yeah, maybe he was better for Liam Cooper in that season, I don't know. But anyway, that's it for today's episode. Remember to like, share, subscribe, comment, do all those good things. Remember to check us out on social media, and I'll catch you later.